Hey everybody, this is Christopher Small from CMS Law Firm. We do estate planning, we do probate, we do it well, and I'm excited to be here with you today, as always. We're going to talk about today whether or not a single member LLC provides the asset protection that most people want, all right? And before we get there though, if any of this sort of sparks and questions or comments or thoughts, you can set up a time to talk with me over the phone or in person for free at any time by going to estatemeeting.com. All right, estatemeeting.com. There you go, mark it down. And okay, so to get into this story, this is a client question from today. I did a will signing with a very lovely woman, and she was creating an LLC for her rental house, and the topic came up about whether or not a single member LLC provides you with asset protection. And the reason that she had, reason she was asking this question and was unsure is because she'd been Googling around and had seen some information that a single member LLC was considered to be a disregarded entity. And I thought to myself, that is a great question. It's a question that comes up often, and it's one that always sort of makes me pause and go, you're right, that seems counterintuitive, that an LLC that's supposed to provide asset protection is also called a disregarded entity. And the reason it's called a disregarded entity is pretty straightforward. It is considered to be a disregarded entity only by one very specific organization, and that is the Internal Revenue Service. Basically, what they're saying is if you open up an LLC in and of itself and conduct business through it, you will get the liability protection that you want if something goes wrong. But as far as they are concerned, any income that is produced by the LLC passes through directly to the owner of the LLC, that single member. So this is important, or can be important, for income taxes and things like that. If you are a single member LLC and you have not done an S corp election under that LLC and you are making money, you probably want to talk to your accountant about that. That, however, is a topic for a different time. But when it comes to disregarded entity and LLC, that is what is being discussed, is that just that classification by the IRS for income tax purposes. In all other circumstances, if you set the LLC up right, and if you conduct it as an actual business, there is a very, very high likelihood, like essentially 100%, that if anything ever happens related to that business, you personally and your personal assets are not going to be subject to liability for those actions. Okay, now real quickly, let me give you a couple of caveats to this, or a couple of things to consider. If you do open an LLC and you start a business with it, whether it's a rental property or anything else, you're going to want to make sure that you open a bank account, and any money that in the name of the business and any money that comes in through the business goes to that bank account. Any expenses that you pay should come out of that bank account, right? The whole point of this LLC is to create a separate entity, so you should treat it like one, okay? If you do distributions to yourself personally, then you should do them cash out, and then go take that cash to buy whatever you want personally. Don't buy personal things with business funds, okay? It's bad business, pun intended. Another consideration to make, there was gonna be another one, but I can't remember what it was. But that's the biggest part, I think, right there, is to ensure that you separate business activities. Oh, the other thing I was gonna say was this. A limited liability company will limit your liability if something happens within that business. But if you yourself are grossly negligent, if you are an improper actor, then there is a possibility that someone could sue you personally for that action, even though it's done under the guise of the company. Okay, so this is getting like a little tortious. We're getting outside of estate planning for sure. So if you have questions about this, please, please, please consult an attorney for questions about this. But all in all, the general point that I'm trying to make is, if you create an LLC, even if you're a single member, you're going to get the asset protection that you want. And disregarded entity language that you see is related to the IRS and their rules related to income tax and the income that is earned by that business. All right, that is it. As always, if you have questions, comments, concerns, or you just want to chat, go to estatemeeting.com. You can set up a time to talk with me for free, in person or over the phone, 30 minutes or so, And I'd love to talk to you, estatemeeting.com. Excuse me. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you know someone that needs to hear it, please share it with them. If you have a question or comment, you can also leave it below. I'd be happy to answer them. And that's it. So have a great day, have a great week, great everything. Still nice outside. Let's go enjoy it. All right. Till tomorrow.